Well, I always compare a truck driver to a soldier on the border. These truck drivers are soldiers on the highways. Now, without these truck drivers, all of us cannot live. Where do we get our water? How do we get our newspaper? Be it anything, without the truck drivers, I don't think we all of us can live the life the way we are living. I think we'll have to go to caves.
See, the kind of work a driver does, we really don't appreciate. Whether it is a white good or a finished, whatever the finished good, whatever it is, when they carry from the factory gates to the nooks and corners of India, in a way they are the ambassadors for these companies. While the goods they carry have the logo, but these drivers don't have anything. They may be, you know, ugly, uncouth, whatever it is, but ultimately they are the real ambassadors carrying the message, carrying the products, so that the ultimate user is really able to relish and enjoy the product.
We all know that we have three modes of transportation. We can go by air, we can go by sea, and we can go by road. Now just look at air, be it a passenger or a cargo. Who drives the aeroplane? It is the pilot. And how is a pilot respected in this country? How does he live his life? And then look at a trucker. There's no comparison. But I'm sure all of you all will agree that all the three drive, right? It is just the same driving a truck, driving an aircraft, or a ship. What Transport Mitra wants to do is bring about this change, that we all start respecting a truck driver too, like a pilot or a captain. I want all of you all watching this video to make this change happen.
See, it's very pathetic. You know, like even you and I, white collar workers, fall sick. We have medical leave, okay? And possibly we are also covered under some insurance scheme, either provided by the company for whom we work, or many times we also take our own insurance to cover the health risk. Whereas the drivers are very unaware, or even if they are aware, their affordability to avail of any of this insurance scheme is negligible. I'll tell you a very interesting case. There is a guy called Rajkumar Nai from Etawa. The guy met with an accident sometime in June, July 2014, in a midnight accident. The fleet owner, for whom he was working for more than 8 years, incidentally, he started working as a Kalasi, as a driver assistant in the same company before he graduated into a driver. He met with an accident and he lost his leg below the knees on the left hand side and couple of toes on the right hand side. The owner just dumped him in a government hospital and just handed over a few thousand rupees to his wife and gone away. Okay, by a sheer luck, he managed to get hold of our telephone number, got in touch with us. Then we took charge of him. Over the last 12 plus, more than a year's time, we really rehabilitated him. During his medication, okay, we gave him money to his family, to him, and he had a 8th class studying son and a primary school daughter. We took care of both these children's education. And once his surgery got over and he recovered, he said he wanted to move around. He wanted a little bit of mobility. That time we pooled money together and gave him a physically handicapped cycle so that he can move around. So this kind of, many of these rehabilitation programs we are doing. So it all can happen only with support from people like you who are watching this and shelling out some money so that, it's sort of a crowdsourcing. When you all give money, so it goes to a right cause. So that's the way to go about it. Rehabilitation is very, very vital. That way we bring life back to him. Thank you.